Stickers can really liven up your videos, especially the arrow sticker, because it lets you do things like pointing here, and here, and here, and here. Another useful section in the sticker area is the detail, which lets you do this to your face. Here's how they both work, starting with the arrow sticker. Start by opening InShot, and in the spirit of this video, I'm going to use the arrow sticker to point to every button that you need to press. Hopefully it doesn't get too annoying. And go to the video section. I'm going to add a new video. And this is the video for the introduction that you just saw. Stickers can really liven up your videos, especially the arrow sticker, because it lets you do things like pointing here, and here, and here, and here. Okay, to make the arrow appear next to each of my fingertips, start by opening the sticker section, which is the smiley face right here. And click on Add Sticker. And you can see there's a whole bunch to choose from, but I like the arrow. So there. Now I'm going to drag through the video timeline to see where I point. Ooh, I point there. So I'm going to click on the yellow sticker part of the timeline and drag it through to the white line because that shows where the video is right now. Things like pointing here and here. Okay, so it popped up at the right time, but not in the right place. So to fix that, click on the arrow in the timeline. I'm going to drag it over to my fingertip right there. Now let's check that again. Pointing here and here and here. Okay, I don't want it to last as long. So let's see, when do I move my finger away? About there. So if I split the arrow here and delete the rest, then it will only pop up for that short little time while my finger is there. Like pointing here and here and here. All right. So because the arrow sticker is quite small on the timeline, I'm going to spread my fingers apart to make it look bigger. And I'd like another arrow there. So I press on the arrow that's in the timeline and move across to copy. And move my second arrow to this part of the timeline. And I'll also need to move it on the screen to the correct place, so over here. And I know that I point, and again, I point at my head. So I'm going to copy the arrow again, move it to this part of the timeline by dragging it with my finger. Now I move it to there, where my finger's pointing to. And I'm pretty sure I pointed one more time. So let's copy again. There. So now I'm going to move this arrow to that part of the timeline. And let's move the arrow up there. So let's check that part.
Like pointing here, and here, and here, and here.
Now I paused again for a bit. So I need to chop that. So I press the split button in my main video timeline. I'm going to go forward to where I start talking, there, split again, and then delete the middle bit.
Another useful section in the sticker area is the detail, which lets you do this to your...
So, when I put my hands up, I want my face to go blurry. So, press on the sticker again. This time choose Add Detail. And there are a lot of options. Lots of different blurry effects you can use. I'm just going to use the normal blur for now. And I'd like to be a circle, like my face. So move it there. I want it to be a bit bigger. There we go. Let's see how that looks.
Let you do this to your face.
And press the tick when you're happy. The next thing you'll need to know is how to make simple animations using the keyframes, which you'll find in the next video right here.